It is said that genius is 99% perspiration and 1% inspiration. Somebody who is willing to keep on trying hard becomes a success. Mahakavi Kalidas, the great poet of Sanskrit literature, how did he ascend to that mastery over Sanskrit language? We have all heard the story. It is said he was so grossly dull in his intellect that he was sitting on the same branch that he was cutting. He didn't even realize that he will fall down with it. And there was this Rajkumari princess who was very scholarly. For her marriage, she had laid a condition: I will only marry that man who can defeat me in Shastrarth, scriptural debate. So big scholars came, they endeavored. She would defeat all of them. So these pundits became annoyed. They said, we will teach her a lesson. Let's get her married to a gross fool. They went around looking and they found Kalidas cutting the tree's branch. They said, he's a fit candidate. They got hold of him and told him, look, you don't open your mouth. We will get you married to the princess. So they tied a big turban around him and they brought him and told the Rajkumari that he is a big scholar. But in present, he is observing Maun Vrat, the vow of silence. So this Shastrarth, scriptural debate, will have to be only by actions. The Rajkumari said, all right. She lifted one finger. Kalidas, he thought, what is she trying to tell me? He lifted two fingers. He thought she is saying, I'll break one of your eyes. So he said, I'll break your both eyes. The pundits asked her, what was your question? She said, my question was, is the supreme entity one or many? So they said, you know what he was trying to say was that he is both Sakar and Nirakar, with a form and formless. That is why he said two. Now the Rajkumari, she lifted her hand, five fingers like this. Kalidas thought she's saying, I'll slap you. So he showed his fist, I'll give you a box. Pandit said, what was your question this time? She said that the five senses are troubling us. What is the solution? They said what he was meaning was, with the help of the mind, you have to control them. In this way, they debated and they defeated her together. Now she got married to this mood, this foolish Kalidas. After marriage, they were sitting on the palace when a camel was going from there. Seeing the camel go by, Kalidas said, Utara, Utara, Utara. The Rajkumari thought that, is he so illiterate he cannot even speak properly? She pushed him from the top of the stairway and Kalidas went rolling down, fell on the ground with a thud. But that insult, he decided to put it to good use. There was a temple of Mother Kali. He offered his respects and vowed that he will become a scholar and come back. He got up and went to Kashi, the city of scholars. He studied there like there was no yesterday and no tomorrow. And he became well versed in Sanskrit language. When he came back after a few years, he knocked on the door and said, Kapatam Dwaram Dehi. My dear wife, open the door. She heard, she recognized. So she said, Asti kaschit vag vishesha. Seems like you have become a great scholar with great proficiency over speech and writing. So those three words she uttered, Asti kaschit and vag vishesha. Mahakavi Kalidas wrote three Mahakavyams starting from each of these three words. So how did he reach that point? Through endeavor, through effort. Similarly, this process of spirituality requires us applying ourselves to it. So practice is important.